make all kinds of rules up that don't make help the people, that hurt the people. He says the majority, but it's not. It's never the majority. It's the majority that get out the vote. The majority are the ones in this motel down the street in two hotels that are homeless. That's the majority that's going on right now. People kicked out their homes. Those are the majority. You think your homes are the majority, but they're not. Glory to God. God has the last day, so. Again, we're going to be in the book of Ephesians, chapter 2, 1 through 8. Ephesians, chapter 2, verses 1 through 8. Come on, everybody, stand on your feet. The word of God is coming right now. Apostle John T.
You want everything, but you don't want to pay. Come on. don't want to pay. You want to play with God, but you don't want to pay God. You want to play God, but you don't want to pay God. You want God to tell you what you want to do, but you ain't want God to pay for what you want to do. Never mind, did that cool me for some drink? So here we are together, just you and I. See, you got these issues. See, you want to play God, but you don't want to pay God. You want to be the big I am, but you don't want to pay off with the ham. I hear what I'm saying. So you don't want to do the work. You want to be God, but you don't want to pay the dues to play God. God is from the school of Lionel Richie. All night long. But see, you don't want to be up all night long. Unless you got a poo in the bed with you. Then you want all night long. Then you're mad because you got short song. And you listen to Beyonce put a ring on, you put a red pant sweatpant on in it. It's like you go to the bar relationship and give me the dirtiest guy in the dirtiest glass. Give me the dirtiest girl in the dirtiest glass. Give me the dirtiest girl in the dirtiest. Dirty. Real dirty. Because you lost focus. You lost focus because she showed you a little muscle. You lost focus because she showed a little booty. You lost focus because you seen a little money. She ain't giving you no money, bro. Hey, he ain't giving you no money, sis. You lost focus. So then, how do you know when you lost focus? Say, how do you know? Because you sleep all the time. You're like the mechanic so poor you can't stand to stay up with yourself. Hallelujah. Woo! Woo! Ouch! Why you go to sleep when you're around everybody? Because you're boring company. Hello, how you doing? Disinterested, you sleep, you put yourself a dollar by yourself to sleep. Let's go talk about something spiritual. You don't focus yourself so much that you were doing a conversation that you done lullabied yourself to sleep with boredom of yourself. Today you're about to cash out the $1 million ticket. Here you go. Ain't mine. But you missed the ball, cashing out the $1 million ticket, I'm going to give you $5,000. You missed that because it's in ain't mine. See, he got that $1 million ticket, didn't give me $5,000 because you went to sleep boring. Don't you know you have boredom issues? You don't have borderline, you have boredom. It is bad when you're boring yourself. You be narcissistic and bore yourself at the same time. That's confusion. You just narcissistic. You just know everything. You got it. You know everything. You got everything. You know everything. You got everything. You know everything. You got everything. You know everything, but you got everything, but you got nothing. And you're boring. You're so boring that the devil don't even mess with you. You got the ultimate masturbation. You are playing with yourself in your own mind. And boring yourself while you're playing with yourself. Oh my God. Y'all get ready for this one today. You are yourself. You want to put your misery on somebody else. Yeah, come on, talk to me. So we can sit here and be bored and all together? I'm going where the excitement is. I'm going where focus is. That's why I have a focus group. It'll be so exciting. You go to the focus group, they stand behind them and catch them. You watch people get the head bust off. Oh, my bad. I couldn't hold you. Focus group. That's where everybody is. Determined to get focused. Yep. How many peanuts is in this jar? About as many as your head. That's how many in that jar. Hallelujah. Focus group. But see, your focus is bad because you're boring. But when you ain't gone, you can't go to sleep. My God, when you get in God, you wake up in the morning and say, good morning. When you wake up in God, like, hallelujah. When you get up in God, when they're out pouring everybody else and there's some excitement going on the inside, coming on the outside, and excitement going inside, coming on the outside. And you got something to talk about.
Big brush, it ain't the
enjoy stuff is because you don't have a point of focus. The reason that you cannot talk to God is because you do not have a point of focus. The reason why you can't get your praise on is because you have a point of focus. See, you didn't come in with a focus. You came in with an idea. You came in with a broad brush. You came in with your greed and your boring stuff. So it doesn't matter how much praise going, you still want something like in your hand because you have a point of focus. Enjoy praise and worship because you don't have a point of focus. You ain't trying to get to the middle of the dark. You just got to get to the bottom of your stomach. You just want to get your sound heard. Stop to get heard. When you play real hard, you sing real hard, you're still boring. There's no praise. People still be looking at. Ain't no Holy Spirit there. But when that Holy Spirit hit, you start coming. Listen, God said, rap ain't got nothing on me. With you, yeah. Ain't no room for it. just shake his head, man. If you ever got up there, you could be a good fight if you just wake up. Thinking that you ain't even waking up, there ain't no fight there. Ain't no point in me messing with you. I know where the action is. So that's why your answer is schizophrenic. You really hope the devil or somebody will mess with you, but. So you start making up stories. You start making up demons messing with you, and it's you messing with you. There's demons bothering me. Why are your hand is all over you? Where did the demon come from? He came in me, made me get me. Well, really, when did that happen? Why was he want to get you for? Because he wants to get me. Why? You're broke. What are you talking about? You already ain't doing nothing. What do you want with you? Well, he just want my nothing. Everybody. Don't matter, I got a finger in my ear. just gonna embarrass me. Y'all just y'all couldn't just judge me. Y'all, I see y'all how y'all doing the thing. Yeah, y'all focus on y'all pockets. Y'all focus on my offering. I ain't give one, but y'all focusing on it. You just want to control me. I ain't got no offering, nothing going on for myself, but you want to control me. I got a finger in my ear. I can't hear.
Why? There you go. Took your finger out.
I think I'm possessed. I think I got mental issues. I need something. I got a finger in my ear. I don't. How you know? Where do you see a finger at? Here you go. You trying to curse me. Tell me I got a finger in my ear. Yeah, you got a knee in your head. How about that one? See, this is what I'm talking about. Y'all, you go over there to that ministry over there, and they sit there and talk about you like a dog. You sit there over there, got a finger in my ear. You know, tell me I got a finger in my ear. I go, do I have a finger in my ear? Do you see a finger in my ear? No, we don't see nothing. Ain't no finger in your ear. See, I told you people is crazy. But until you get someone say, hey, hallelujah, I'm free now. Your focus is so on you that you cannot hear nothing that God is saying. Your focus is so much on your finger in your ear, you can't recognize there's a finger in your ear. Your focus is so much on you, no one can tell you to take the finger out your ear. Focus. Then you got an issue because you don't got no focus. You can't receive grace. The whole time you run around acting a nut, God trying to give you grace, but you won't receive it. You too boring to pick up grace. Y'all want to be faithful, man. I just want to let you know today you're boring. That's why you talk about everybody, talk about every ministry, talk about everything. What about PD? You're boring. You don't have a life, so you want to mess up or cause some confusion or be nosy somehow, like you're boring. You can't, because you can't hear God, because you ain't doing God, because you sitting there looking, living, look casually through everybody else's life that you don't even know. Why is all you people talking about PD? You don't know him. I don't know. I don't know that man doing. I can't say nothing about him. Maybe he is doing something. I don't know. I'm minding my business. Why am I sitting there worrying about what he's doing? What's he got to do with me? Is he getting me a couple hours? Now, PJ, you throwing me a couple hours. Now, we might have to talk about this day. Now, we might need to get something going on. We work on some deliverance, bro. But every man mind my business. Live your life. However that is. So, by grace. So, because you won't receive grace, you can't even be in a place to be used for grace. Because the focus, God wants to fill you up with grace so you can distribute it. Oh, you're listening. So God lets you go through what you go through so you can get focused in it. So you, if you start focusing on God while you're going through something, that thing will lead you and grace will replace it. So you know, I know, listen. I give a prime example. So, Papa's heirs, they said she had to get an operation, and they said she had to get medicine. And I told her, I said, listen, you know why that's going on? She said, why, Dad? Because you still focusing on you. Just let it go right now. Forget about it. And start serving. So after the whole couple months, she was doing everything. She was vacuuming. She was sweeping. She was working down at the Wendy's down there. She's coming in big bags of crab legs and steaks and all kinds of stuff. She's buying everything for everybody that she doing everything she had to do. And all of a sudden, she came back and said, hey, Dad, they told me it's gone. And I'm laughing at her and said, I told you. She said, you know what? There's something to that. That's grace. I said, that sure is grace, baby. Now run with it. So now, years later, God's grace shows up. But God's grace not only shows her, what she got to do, she got to do it. Show up on you. So her children is sitting here doing worship. But she got out of herself, started focusing on God, and every time she knows this to be true, every time she starts to focus on God, God gives more grace. Every time she do something with God, God gives more grace. I'm telling you, that girl could have lost $1 million, and she starts focusing on God, even the $3 million. For some ridiculous, unforeseen reason. Accept the grace. You won't carry the grace that God wants you to carry. cream. That means he gave you grace to give out the ice cream. So that you can give you grace to make sure somebody else don't feel that way. He gave you grace to make sure they're not going through that. But you can't understand that because you're too busy looking at what happened to you. So you can't use the grace for God's glory. So you can't use what happened for God's glory. But he even the guy that happened to you was still grace because he chose you to fix that thing for them. That's why I went through what you were. He chose you to fix it, to be his place of grace. So when grace shows up, he's just about to give up and say, wait a minute, I went through that, and I know that the Lord can. Oh my God, for real. Matter of fact, here, get two of these ice creams real quick. But they ain't going to be worried about the ice cream. They're going to be concerned with the fact that you went through it and looking at you. You look like that after that? Oh, God is good. Yes, he is. Here's the grace. I'm in front of you. Now let's go get some. See y'all got to get this thing right. Whooping down the butt over here, yeah. I'm going to get some. get your hand off your head. I have a t-shirt. God said, get your hand off your head. Y'all are playing in your head too much. Just all in your head. Playing in the sandbox. Why are you in your head? Well, God, you got in the box for us. I know I am. No, I can't get in my head. Ain't nothing in there. But the Lord. Because me is a big empty spot. You could have nicknamed me, I think that. One big inky spot in the middle of my head, because there ain't nothing out here. Don't you know this was wrong with y'all? Out there, I know y'all got the problem here. Okay. But, y'all ain't messing with y'all head, no. No, not the apostle, no. No, it ain't me. I just stopped 2 seconds ago. so in the means of the message, that means we can't count it because that 2 seconds you knew now. So get your dinner time, then we'll find out. You ready, sir? So now we're gonna go to Ephesians chapter 2. I'm gonna take you through this, and then we're gonna praise God on our gift Eve. For real, the rest of the day, the rest of the week, 7 days, you better start partying like a rock star. Ephesians 2:1-8. And it should have, you know, what I wanted to do is I said, Lord, it's the appropriate thing, 1-7. He said, yeah, the 1-7 you're going to get to, but the 8 is going to make it great. So I'm going to add the 8 there. At the 8. Check, I'm telling you how I came with this, what he said. So he said, look, verse 1. And you have quickened, say, yeah, quickened. Yeah. So corny. Let's go get born. And he had quickened.
And he has quickened.
Don't you want to be quickened?
Yeah.
How you going to get it like that? He said, yeah. And station break. Listen, y'all. You're not quickened. You out there fighting the devil like this. Give me now, Devin. Give me now. Stop letting me. It's time. Yeah. Or you out there windmilling.
Oh.
Hitting that windmilling at the devil. Not hitting nothing. But if you want to take him down and upset him bad while he's going down, then when you talk about being quick and say it to him like you're going to punch him in the face. Every time you say something to the word of God toward the devil, talk like you punch him in the face. Don't windmill, don't win. Yeah. So, let me go try this again. Okay. Here we go. Okay. I need a drink. No, it's not an alcoholic beverage, but if it wasn't, you will never know. Now I'm drinking again. I said, surely he's crazy, he got to be drunk. No, no, I'm high in the spirits.
Yeah, that's right.
Not the spirits, but high in the spirits. And he said, he quickened. So he just told you right now, in your seat, that you quickened. You should be coming ass up there, I'm quickened, buddy. You don't want none of this. Right here. Your sins, your trespasses. officially dead. Such a hypocrite. Whoops. I thought you were quick here, but you keep acting like God didn't do it for you. So you keep going back in your past and going back in your head because you, listen, you need to go to Mind Spiritual Masturbation Anonymous. You need it bad. You keep denying the Lord that way. You keep listening, and listen, that's why I won't let you tell me about your past stuff. I don't want to hear it.
You know, all of a sudden, I'm like, bro, I already know, who cares?
I love you. Let's do this. All right, so what? I'm just saying, hey, what do I care about that? You and me. We together. We know what we doing. Don't matter. Who care how bad it was? I've heard some pretty bad things. Just a little earlier. That was nothing. I'm talking about bad stuff. But guess what? Them folks that had that bad stuff was the ones that served out. The ones that say, yo, I did such and such, da 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 da, they serve the Lord. Yeah. And they came. Once they say, look, that was that, then we don't leave it there, we didn't get there, Pastor. We went on. They were great. I had a father's name, Elder McDaniels. That was the baddest man that ever lived. Because when he finally said, I'm letting the past go, him and I, we could get at it too. I was like, Pop, I know you're older than me, but I'm still your apostle. You can't do that. See, you out of pocket. You little Jerry Bud, I'm older than you, so I'm your apostle, so it don't matter. You're my elder, but I'm your apostle. See, here you go. You got pull rank, y'all. You pull rank.
Nah, Papa, I play a little hard too. We gon' it's over. We go out there and go shop and go get something to eat. See, cause that's the way it's supposed to be. But we never, ever, ever came back to any past arguments or situations that we ever had. Because that is not God. That is not God. And if you show me about behavior in this new year, I'm gonna get rid of you. Because you were the devil. I can't be bothered with that. I don't want to hear that about what happened back then. Who cares? It's what's happening now. Oh, that's right. You want me to be boring like you. You don't even have to argue unless you can dig back in a file. You know how weak that is? You didn't call me all that shit and the year before that. You didn't call me. That's why I don't think you no good. No good old nigga. That's weak. That's so weak. It's the devil. You and your mind masturbation. I can't join you. Don't shake my hand either. I'm just saying. Y'all don't want to hear about that out there because I use the proper terminology. It's PG-13, but it's the truth. That's what's wrong with y'all. You want somebody to sit there and help you mind masturbate? Seriously, y'all are coming over there and boxing John Jesus. I'm a back. I go to church. Oh, I ain't going to that church, so you can't go to my church. First off, the Bible said, put this back on the left here. I'm a church. The building is sanctuary, so you can't. I went my church. You need to build your own. You might you can't come to my church, you know? Well, you just so hurt my feelings. I'm gonna come at church. Okay, now what? See more mental masturbation. You proved it. Look at you. Look at your life. You're going to hell. You have no sanctuary to go to, so when you die, you don't have nowhere to put the jar. They gotta take you down to one of the parlors somewhere and put you in the jar. My father's house. You don't get put in the jar. You get in a nice casket. You go to a nice place. You have a police escort. The whole thing, everything taken care of at this house. You don't have to do a GoFundMe at this house for anything. So don't come to this house. Go to that church. But here it is. So dead in trespasses and sin. Are you dead in trespasses and sin right now? Are you ready to get saved? You know what I did is what I did. And you still gonna do some stuff. You ain't gonna ride. Come on now. I guarantee there's a more matters than anyone dog out there. And every now and then they slip out when you get pissed off. Come on now. Now, man, we might go another home to Sam, because we don't want to get that damn dead bobcat in there. We're going to gonna say it to you, though. But then you don't turn into berserk or lion.
Yeah, you call me back!
Well, you're being a saint after that. You turn into a whole wicked monster anyway. So we're dead in our trespasses and sins. That's the first thing. Second verse. Did y'all get there? Give me a pen. I'm out there now. Give me a pen. All right. Now here comes the grace. Where in time past, you walked according to the course of this world. According to the prince of the power of the air. There you go. You was an airhead. The spirit now worketh in the children of disobedience. Now, station break. We're going to talk about it. See, that's how you know you're an airhead. Because you're disobedient. You're just an airhead. You're a child of the prince of the air. You're airhead. This is where I'm being disobedient. Don't even know why. Don't put your finger in the socket, Billy. Yeah, he's just trying to control me. He's trying to control me. Ah! I got buzzed up because you were trying to control me. That's why I got shot. It's your fault.
mess with the instruments over in the pulpit there. They're sacred. She ain't sacred. It's broke. It ain't working. See? She broke it. It ain't working. See, the apostle, I'm telling you right now, it ain't, look what she did to him. Beat him, it ain't working. See, she being funny, she broke it. Now, what you gonna do to her? She broke it. She was sitting up here. I knew that girl wasn't anointed. I knew she was not about the Lord. It ain't working. She put, I put, look, y'all look and see. Look at this. Look at everybody. Look, I'm telling you, she ain't anointed. Look over here. Look at this. Girls, you got that cute guy. Look over here. Look at this thing right here. You see me? You see me banging on these keys? Do you see me? It ain't working.
And all of a sudden, she. Oh, she doing witchcraft.
That thing was broken. I know it was broken. You seen it. It was not working. She trying to make me look bad for the pastor. That's all. But I know what you about, Huffer. I see what it is. Now, we leave out the fact that I was disobedient, because if I was obedient, I would say, push the button, and now it works. If you want to use it, push the button, and now it works. But because I'm the child of disobedience, I'm an airhead, I just wandered my way into something I had no business being in, touched something I had no business being in, and then got the nerve to come back and try to dump her out and tell her she ain't anointed, and I'm not minding my business. I'm disobedient. Boy, I didn't know that. I was going to tap some toes on this one. So, if you are walking in the quickening, you can't be disobedient. Amen. See, you got the quickening means when God say go, you go fast. Like people that said now faith. That means you're going now. God say go, you go. You're going to go. Okay. When God say go, go ready. Say go, go. You just jump out. You don't even think about it. Not you. God said, go out the door. Because you're quick. But if you walk into disobedience, you're going to have a bunch of questions. Questions going to lead to judgment. Judgment's going to lead to complaints. And complaints means you have got everything out of focus. Now there's no focus, there's no quickening. Where there's no focus, there's no grace. So if you do all these things, disobedience, say
disobedience
takes away
focus,
grace,
and the quickening.
Then
my gift
is delayed. Uh-oh. Y'all getting it right today?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Because I'm getting my gift today. Y'all do what I want to. I'm getting mine. It says, verse 3, among whom also we all had our conversations in times past. Told y'all. In the lust of our flesh. So when you sit there and talk about the past, that's lust in your flesh. But what is that flesh lusting for? Self-gratification. Self-validation. They talk about their past, you won't see that pleasure button go way up. Because they start to feel good talking about their misery. I don't know about this. I don't
bad names, everything. Spit on me, kick me, roll me on the ground. And I was sad. And I went to the police, I told them they do nothing. And he's still running around, getting away with it. I don't know why he did it. Yo, but you left out the fact that you hit him with a bus. He tear it apart. But then on top of that, you still feel good about talking about the misery. Listen, look how good. You ready? You ready? You ready? Anything that don't really feel good to you, you don't mess with it no more. You don't eat, you don't like liver, you won't eat no liver. So you can't tell me you ain't like to talk about this misery when you keep going back to it. Oh, come on, talk. You like it. Let's think about this. And don't tell me that you got low self-esteem. Because if you got low self-esteem, you really don't want to look at yourself for nothing. You're not talking about yourself, you got low self-esteem. But you keep telling me about the problem, keep talking about you, you got high self-esteem. So if you're low self, you don't want to talk, they just sit there and you can avoid it somewhere. You keep talking about it, you got high. You thinking about shit. Uh-oh. I'm about to put some psychologists out of work. See, y'all know this to be true. You know that you're making money off the enjoyment of their lustful flesh for the pain. You know that why they keep talking about because they like it. And you get paid to hear. If you're sitting in here right now, you just keep going in your head
and going in your past, you don't, it ain't the, that ain't the problem. You like it. You need to deal with that problem. You're addicted to your misery. You're addicted to your pain and your anxiety. If you are still going back in your head and going, you're doing it because you like it, and you're upset because nobody won't join you in it. Ain't no medicine gonna help you with that. Because you like it. You're addicted to your situation. You're addicted to your pain. You're addicted to your disobedience. You are addicted. You are an airhead. A child of the air. You are addicted to your mess. And get back if nobody will join you in your addiction part. Get back if they can't pump up. Sitting up under the road, pushing the stove with all the kids. That man has ambition. That man wants to serve God. She not minding God business with him, even if she don't know him. He's doing what he needs to do. She supporting what he needs to do. They doing what they need to do. She ain't got a whole lot of this, even though she got a whole lot of that. And she, and then when it's time to say, hey, let's do what we do, she coming to the table with it. And she got the pork chops. Girl, I know that's right. That's what you did to me. She told on herself. I just thought about that. She hit me with some smoked pork chops. I was jacked up. Oh, man. Wasn't the bouillon beauty, it was the pork chop. You wrong. You so wrong. No, see what it is again, the focus. See, everything gravitates to something that has a focus and it's other than their self. And when you got something that focuses in the grace show, when you get with people and focus, and this is why even with this new program that God is doing, I gotta have the people that got the focus involved. But see, when we all got the focus, we can do something. When we got that same, we're gonna have to do something. This man, I think the devil's messing with me. I don't know. Life won't cook me no more pork chops. I don't know what's going on. I don't know what happened. Why is she acting this way? Well, I did pick up my shoes and left stuff all over the floor, but I'm a man. I mean, she should know this is how it is. So the problem being my pork chops and everything. Now she ain't talking. Even though I just keep screaming at her, hollering at her, don't hear nothing she got to say, but I'm just saying, Pastor, what you want me to do? Well, bro, you got a problem, bro. You got a problem. For one, stop screaming at her. For two, pick this stuff up. Use a whole grown. Get them dirty drawers on the floor. That's me, how I know. I stopped playing that game a long time ago. She hit me with the sergeant slaughter like. Oh, man. Baby, it's just drugs. This step. I'm a man. Oh, but this is the part that gets me. Fulfill the desires of the flesh and of the mind. That's how you know you're airheaded. You keep running with the prince of the air in your mind. Now you know you're airheaded because you keep listening to the prince of the air. See, so he said in your mind. So your mind is a terrible thing to waste. Stop wasting it on you. And then wonder why at the end of the day it's just you. Whoops! And whereby nurture the children of wrath, even as others. Wow. That's why you so angry all the time. So miserable. Joy. You like droopy dog, you devil, but that make me mad. Everything make you mad. That's why. You're mad because nobody want to join you and play with you in your mind. I don't want to play with your mind. It's a terrible thing to waste. You right there, man.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, see, somebody said, that he wouldn't see say, it's the word, it's right there. It's the word. Hello. You're getting no vows, but you're getting the word. That's a problem. That's a problem right here. Because I didn't know, yeah, I
for it. So, but watch this. Verse 4. But God, who is rich in mercy. So while you sit up there playing with yourself in front of God, now think about that. Every time you get up in your head, you sitting in front of God playing with yourself. Think about that. If that don't mess you up, you tell God, I don't care what you say, I'm enjoying myself. I like this misery. I like my past. Why are you trying to take it away from me? Why are you saying, Apostle, tell me not to do that no more? I'm mad. I'm so mad. Why are you saying all that? Why are you talking about me? Why are you talking to yourself? Why are you mad? Because the word just said you're full of wrath because you want somebody to join you to play with you. Ooh. I'm going to need security. Don't leave right away. You might have to protect me. Listen. Somebody, who's my food taster? I'm going to need a food taster. I'm going to find somebody that don't love the Lord here. Try this. But seriously, God, hear this right word. But God, which is rich in mercy, he has great love wherewith he loved us. So even though you sit there being the most worst possible you can be and you don't care nothing about him, he's still caring about you. Because if you care about him, you put him in your mind. You put his word in your mind. Yes, his word is beautiful. Yes. His word is life. Yes. His word is prosperity and power. His love is the essence of what love is. The love is not a feeling. It's the living spirit of God. You can't get the living spirit of God until you get the word of God to bring the living spirit to you. You can't get the living spirit of God until the quickening happens to you. So a lot of you are not experiencing love because there's no quickening in you. You're born in your dead. Your trespasses were dead. You had to join your trespasses. Now you're trying to do Lazarus when you give a mouth-to-mouth resuscitation on your past. Come back. Every day. I don't care nothing what happened last week. That was last week. I'm not doing no mouth to mouth with my past. We got quiet in here. This hurts my toe. Now he comes back in the fifth verse and says, even when we were dead in sins. So he said to you, you were dead in the sins. You was all up in it, just dead. So he said, that's why I'm telling y'all. So now when you're sitting around looking at me crazy, you know what I'm thinking, right? You're boring and you're dead. And you're dead. I saw me looking at you. Look at you. Look at your airhead. Look at you. Wee. 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 I mean, seriously, you got to get rid of that right now. Right now. You got to make up your mind not to be boring no more. God has lied. You say, ain't nothing to die, boy. You come across somebody and somebody got to be boring, ain't lying. I'm telling you, a very exciting life. Even in my quiet time, it's lit. If you help me, we have a ball. It don't matter what's going on. We're going to have a good time. I don't care. You could look. You could listen. I'm telling you. My sister passed away. I was laughing and joking. They're like, what's wrong with you? Okay, shit, to be absent from the body, to be present with the Lord, and this is child. She went home. She went there. I love her. I'll see you when I get there. She went at me. See me get there. What's she going to do? Oh, she gone. I keep telling y'all best stop running around here empty-handed. There's a mind out there waiting for she back in the day.
for it, but it's another one that chooses you.
Yeah.
honest, let me tell you something. You know what? You're an airhead. Now get yourself together. Now y'all did you anybody know if you've been on the phone with me, it ain't all funny games. Sometimes you want some dumb stuff. I'm gonna tell you about it. I'm gonna love you. I'm saying that I'm done with this nice thing, you see? That's all. And it is not because listen, first off, you're not getting punished. You're getting corrected. God chastised and punished, not me. Stop it, nice. Stand in the corner and look at the wall and I punish you. If that ain't happening, stop that nonsense. Correction comes from the leader. Amen. So you got the chastisement comes from God. Oops.
We got to make sure we don't disturb the man of God. He's sitting in front.
She can't see no man parts. She can't see no lady parts. Hallelujah. There it is. See, this is the church of the way, the wayside, the backside. This is us, right? Cash App, us, and I said, peace of it. Yes, the prophet so and so. I'll tell you how this is going to work. God deliver us. And there's your commercial. But I just embarrassed y'all. I just did some ridiculous nonsense. All because you was dumb enough to expose yourself. Here we go, because something in your mind told you, I must go to the house of God and tell all my business. I thought it was God. I thought y'all knew your business. So coming in and telling them your business is going to get you what? Embarrassed and give them a reason to keep. Listen, I know that you got a lust problem. I'm telling you right now, we're going to set you on loose. Now, when I call you, right, you know, my time is valuable. If you want to get to this thing, right, my Cash App is so-and-so, because, you know, it's better to give than to receive. You know? You should bless them in a moment. Yes. Listen, bro. You got a lust problem. You need to get yourself a wife, all right? So I think she might be good for you, but I got to do some studies, some counsel. See if she's just right for you. Okay, we're gonna get this right. Okay, we're gonna work this on some study and some counsel, because she may not. But until then, you need to sit back there somewhere. Now, see what I did was I took away the temptation. Okay, because you don't need the temptation. The Lord just showed me you got a lot of temptation at 12 o'clock at night. I see your Facebook name blinking, so I trust that there's a. I see your Instagram, so I know that. And truly, your TikTok, you don't stop. I'm telling you right now. You be TikToking and you don't stop. And I know this. So we have to really work on this thing in you, okay? Listen, people of God, I'm telling you right now, there's lust going on everywhere, and we need to watch the TikTok, you don't stop. I see everybody TikTok. Hello, how you doing? Okay. Pastor, we're going to get that sanctuary together. I'm telling you right now, we're going to work on it. Meanwhile, I've got 1,000 for you. I've got 300 for you. 100 over there for you. And for real, you got all excited because you thought you were going to finally get a little piece of land. You didn't get enough. You just got your pocket empty. They ain't trying to give up nothing. They just trying to get that money. So you should not be in the business in the house of God, because that's not a great thing. Exposing yourself, exposing people, passing judgment, and messing in your head. God said, get out of your head. He said, look. And he brings us up together. It's 3 days. And they multiplied. And seven oaths. Yes. See, the problem is, I'm not going 4 years out there. I'm going my 3 days. I'm today. So listen. The only reason why the children of Israel didn't make the 3 days is because they want to take their past birth. See, they want to take their own stuff with them. They want to take their own goods with them. They had the steaks, the chicken, they had everything. But they want to take it with them, keep it for themselves, and ask God for extra. Then they turn around and insult God by taking and making a golden calf and then cooking that stuff. Come on, God. When they left out with Jesus, they was all full of infirmities. They was jacked up. So do God got to jack you up to go for 3 days? They was obedient after they got that butt whooped. They didn't have nothing. When they went out to get in and come, they didn't have nothing. It's the blood to carry with them. Heartaches to carry with them. They can cancel whatever, carry it with them. Cancer was there then. But cancer evolved from leprosy. Cancer went out there and get under the hiding of leprosy. Oh, Jesus. So, do you have to go to 3 days to get your... See, they had a focus then. See, they didn't get their focus until something went real bad. Dude, that got to happen to you? Uh-oh. See, y'all listen out there. They did not want to follow God where he was supposed to go in the time he was supposed to do it until it went really bad. They ain't going to be there. I'm going straight for the heavenly place. I want to be in the heavenly places. I want to be in the heavenly place at the bank. I want to be in the heavenly place at the supermarket. I want to be in the heavenly place in the car. I'm in a heavy place in the sanctuary. I'm in a heavy place in my head. I'm in a heavy place in my house. I'm in a heavy place in my praise. I'm in a heavy place in my worship. I'm in a heavy place in the things that come out of my mouth. I'm in a heavy place in the things that come out of my mouth.
Praise
him. Praise him. Praise him, I praise him. Praise him.
grace. You need the grace. You need the grace. You need the focus. Get out your mind.
Thank you.
this race, find yourself a place that you can go to where you can be used by God and you can give and receive the gift of God. So Apostle Thomas was third in line to use ministry today. By grace,
for the record, I'm not asking for one dollar.
trusted that you can put them through, the grace is gonna leave. You're gonna miss it. So take this last attempt of grace for you to get it right. As for me, I never hear it anyway. Because if you ain't capital G-O-D, don't matter. I swim in the river of grace. And I dive in the ocean of grace. I'm soaking wet in grace. Remember what we said today? Keep your eyes on these people of God and do the right thing. Some of y'all, you see them, do an offering. You don't have that much. I don't want it. I'm telling you, when you see them, if you see them, do not pass by them without giving some type of offering. It's owed and it's due for what you did. Make it right. You know, I'm going to pray your strength, Lord. They don't need the strength of the Lord. You need some redemption. This is your way to get it. I'm telling you what to do. You gotta do it. Now, mind you, this is what I'm saying. I'm not asking you to give me nothing or come to me. I'm telling you when you see them. You'll bless them all the time. They blessed you and what you did to them. And you think nobody saw it? I saw it. And other people saw it too. So you owe them. And pay them back what you owe them too. By the way. And put your mouth on them. No longer. Touch them. Warning. Ask one of my people out there on Facebook, they stop being thieves. So, you just get on the line, you sit there and watch stuff, you say you connect to many stuff, you never do it off, you never do it time, you never do nothing. You just sit there and just steal. And that's okay, but understand you will never receive the full gift until you actually do right. You need to do right. Some of y'all were supposed to give and did not give. And that's okay. Well, he don't need no money. You're right, I don't. I don't want no dirty money. I don't want nothing more than attention. And the reason why your life is going where it's going because you did not give like you're supposed to. And it takes a lot of people like that. There's a lot of pastors that you should have gave to them. You need to find them. You need to do the right thing. The house of God went through a lot through COVID. You need to do right. That house of God closed down was because of you because you didn't give. You didn't take care of the house of God. You didn't help a man of God recover from what was going on. You need to get your life right. You need to do right. Even though he wasn't doing right, don't get me wrong, he probably wasn't in a dirty skeleton, but that's beside the point. This apostle witness again saying, look, we love you. I love you enough to tell you about yourself. Be blessed and out the next pastor test so you can hear the rest. See y'all next week. Mom prayers out.